concert is my tribute to India's nature. We're all here because we love India. So this is our namaste to India as a gem on this planet. And this concert is also my personal tribute to Dr. Erich Barucha, who has shown me so much about India's environment.
My greatest love is the wilderness. I visited many parks and sanctuaries in India, more than 70 now, some of them many times. And they've always been a fantastic experience, and very diverse experiences. I love the Western Ghats with its hotspots of vegetation, which are extremely precious today. Evergreen forest, semi-evergreen forest. So very diverse, so very different. And each time I visit the Western Ghats, because that's the closest wilderness area for me, it's an increasingly sense, it's a tremendous sense of wonder.
The most loving thing about nature, I love the rising of sun. It's really beautiful. I love the rainy season. I like the fog in the winter. I like to go for a walk in the early in the morning. I just love nature.
By a creator. It is the home of many voiceless lives. Don't destroy their homes with the help of knives. Nature is the thing that the earth really deserves. I don't know why people on the earth do not preserve. Responsible for today's atmosphere is a man. Nature is trying on pollution to put a ban. And so, nature is very precious to us. Trees are our friends first.
is probably the most degraded part of the Western Ghats. But in the degraded area, we find little patches of green with incredible forest cover and a very high diversity of life. It has been preserved through local traditions, as it is believed that the forest is sacred. Groves all over India, deities like this tiger goddess are venerated, and the forest patches dedicated to them are strictly protected. People have believed that if you cut a branch of a tree in this forest without taking permission of the deity, a calamity will befall them in their village or in their family. Utilization of resources from the grove is controlled by rituals. Whichever of these two grains of rice falls first provides an answer from the goddess as to whether a tree can be cut or not. As local traditions begin to disappear due to development processes, we will have to find alternatives to the traditional means of saving forests. School children who live around the sacred grove to visit their grove and understand its traditional values and its new value in terms of biodiversity conservation. And we've also taken urban children along with these rural kids to the sacred grove where they can interact and talk to each other about the forest that they see. And their expressions of delight are sometimes very, very rewarding for us to watch. And I feel we have been able to change their concepts on why we need to conserve forests.
Hasat bijdi nisar dongar udata tuni gheti nirde kade kapari rano rani nad nachra bare jikade tikade panch pani khalkal nare jare.
environmental programs in India tend to focus more on women, because it's the woman who's involved with natural resources, and perhaps educating her, enhancing her awareness level can bring about conservation much faster. Because it is the woman that is involved with the task of fetching water, she's involved with the task of collecting fuel wood. We've had examples while we were working in the Western Ghats of women who told us that they used to get up at 3 a.m. in the morning to just go and collect water for their families. It was a 2-hour walk either way. If you look at the time span that she was spending almost half her life collecting water. Solid waste management, traffic, air pollution. You have wildlife which is sequestrated in areas all over India with conflicts between these very endangered species and local people's livelihoods. Women know the problems of their own surroundings and they also want to look at solutions. They're willing to campaign for these things, they're very bold, they're willing to question decision makers. You have to not only build awareness amongst women, but also the competency and the skills to be able to deal with these problems. Every person needs to look at their own lifestyles, need to look at the impact of their actions on the environment, because I think at the end of the day, it's your actions that are going to matter the most. It's your own lifestyle that is going to matter the most.
I plant a tree on my birthday. Until it grows up, I take a very kind care of it. We have lot of place on earth, so we can plant anywhere the trees.
शिव सुंदरा जनसंख्येच्या भाराने रडते आहे शिव सुंदरा जनसंख्येच्या भाराने रडते आहे हा नाश थांबवा हा नाश थांबवा हा नाश थांबवा
12% of India's population is in schools, many of them in rural schools. And so we believe that if you catch them young at that stage, we'll bring about a mass environment education movement, which can really change the face of this country. And perhaps that is what we need most. Learned a lot about conservation education in India over the last 20-30 years. We have an environment educator from our institution who accesses each school at least once a fortnight and actually runs a program with the school teacher. And so I believe that what actually begins to happen after a while is that a school program begins to by itself sort of move into communities. And there was this little girl who was told, well, go and tell your parents about this. And she talked to them about garbage management. And from this, a Mahila Mandal, which means a community set up, an NGO for women in that community, first time. So we had now a school program growing into a community program practically spontaneously.
प्लास्टिकने घातला जगाला विळखा धोका त्याचा सर्वांनी ओळखा प्लास्टिक पिशव्या वापरणार नाही निर्धार असा करायचा नाही भागायचं कबूल म्हणून दाखवायला हवं तसं तसंच वागून कबूल 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 कबूल
पोल्युशन इज इंक्रीजिंग सो फास्ट इंस्टंटली सो वी हॅव टू टेक प्रिकॉशन्स फ्रॉम नाउ अँड इट हॅज टू बी डन युनायटेडली
आणि ढगात पाणी म्हणून पाऊस म्हणतो गाणी रानात ऊन उन्हात रान म्हणून हिरवळ फुलते छान वाऱ्यात गंध गंधात वारा म्हणून पाखरांना झाड निवारा पानांच्या कानात फुलांचे डूल म्हणून तर रानाला पडते भूल गगनात चंद्र चंद्रात गगन धरतीवर चांदणे छुमछणन धरतीवर चांदणे छुमछणन
इथं आल्यावर तरी असं वाटतं की निसर्गामधील ही झाडे पक्षी प्राणी तर माझे जसं काही मित्र आहेत नातेवाईक आहेत मला खूप त्यांच्या सहवासामध्ये राहून आनंद वाटतो
Thank you.
Among the many very sensitive ecosystems in my country, probably one of the most threatened are the Himalayas. As human pressures on them keep growing with increasing activity of local people, many of the Himalayan natural forests, which were a mix of conifer and broadleaf forests, have become highly degraded, fragmented forest systems. This has led to increasing pressures for local people because they collect all their fuel wood, fodder, and a whole lot of other natural products from the forest ecosystems. Local people around these sensitive ecosystems like the Himalayas need resources, and they are the poorest of the poor, very often of tribal communities, whose total life depends on the forests. And they feel alienated if they are not allowed to collect these resources. If we can give them alternate sources of income, their pressure on the biodiversity of these protected areas automatically falls. Using locale-specific skills is a very important part of creating alternate income generation for local people who live in very sensitive ecological systems. One of the unique projects that we at Bharati Vidyapeeth have taken around Dudhwa Tiger Reserve in Uttar Pradesh was linking the local crafts, baskets, they're made of bamboo and other artifacts that are made of grass, which local people have made for generations, and making those into a product that becomes marketable. They need to understand that in some way, the protected area is actually helping them financially. Several local NGOs in the Himalayas support such activities where local people use their own skills, for instance, in weaving, so that they can earn a living which would reduce the impacts on the forest ecosystem. India is considered one of the world's mega diversity nations, and that is where all our future wealth lies. But we shouldn't be asking local people to pay the price of conservation.
I came from Manipur, the northeastern part of India, and here the nature is very, very close to our way of our life. And when I was young, when the rain comes, I used to go and dip in the ponds, in the nalas, and swim in the ponds. These are my childhood with nature. When I was 19, 20 years and I realized other places are totally different from my place, because I miss those rivers where I can go and drink the water, and some of the rivers in India is even I cannot go and swim there. But when I go back to my place, still they are all very good, nothing, no industry, no pollution. Just I go still there and I drink from ponds, I drink from river.
I grew up in the north of Scotland, which is one of the most wild and unspoiled corners left in Europe. For the last 15 years, I have been coming to India, and the reason is I was seeking for something inside. India has a vast space which is intangible but can be felt, especially in meditation. And I just feel, although India has such a rich inner world, why not take care of the outer world also?
There is all around greenery, there will be fresh air, and this I like. If I'm tired, then immediately that thing will come in my mind, let's go and sit in the nature. I'll get refreshed again.
If I say in general, you know, without music, there is no life. You look around in the nature, there is music, there is harmony, there is balance, there is a flow. Everything is in tune, as it is. When I look at a tree, it reminds me of how music should be, or how I should be. A tree is not trying to become something. A tree is just is. Who cares about the name and fame and glamour and money? For me, that would be the point as a musician.
जाएंगे मौसम आएंगे जाएंगे मौसम आएंगे जाएंगे मौसम आएंगे जाएंगे हम तुमको भूल पाएंगे मौसम आएंगे जाएंगे मौसम आएंगे जाएंगे जब
musicians, we don't have that much to give. We can just touch people's hearts, to help raise people's awareness, to make them think about things, to make them appreciate how beautiful it is, how fragile it is, how easily it's going to be lost. I've seen India for 28 years, and I've seen it go down. The air pollution get worse, the poverty get worse, but there's still so much beauty here, so much beauty in the people. Still so much innocence, so much joy, still so much friendliness.
I love everything about nature, definitely. The sky, clouds, flowers, colors, I like very much. The sound, the morning. What else to say? Everything is beautiful.
Often capturing a moment of wilderness is really where truth begins. I mean, that's something which you can hold forever and ever.
One of my first experiences I remember about what nature does to me is when I was a kid and I was standing on the walls of the city in Morocco and watching the horizon. The clouds, the distance, the skies, the seagulls. And for me as a musician, when I think of sound, it's always with a picture of nature.
Nature for me, I feel, is my soul and the deepest inspiration for music and for whatever feelings that goes inside of me.